Thank you. Oh, that's right. We got company coming. I better turn on all those candles.
Yeah, it's a little dark in here.
Oh, that's so much better. Oh, there they are. Welcome, guests. Welcome to our home tonight. This is my lovely wife, Charlene.
This is my lovely husband, Garland.
And we've been married for how many years now, sweetie? A few decades.
Too long.
Too long.
Too long. That's my
opinion. That's right, no more. Well, anyway, we are going to tell you a great story upon our little town here, our western town. The year is 1871. Can someone guess the name of this town? Anyone? Just what do you think the name of this town is?
Polly World?
Yeah. That's
right. That's right.
We moved to Polly World 20 years ago.
20 years ago. It's been a long...
Really 20 long years. 20 years.
Now, why is it called Polly Town? Can someone guess as to why it's called that? It's Polly Animals. That's right. We're a forward-thinking group here. You know?
We haven't been able to implement that into our home. Unfortunately.
No, we have, as much as we try.
We have tried.
See,
thanks,
our,
darling.
This Polly town here is full of a lot of crazy characters, wouldn't you say?
I would say it is full of many characters, because we're known here, especially for a kind of industry.
That's right.
I can't remember what that industry is. What is the town of Pollyville known for?
Sugar canes,
yeah, that's right.
We had the sweetest, oh, you remember our honeymoon with all that sugar cane?
How could I forget? All right, now, we're going to tell you a tale that happened here in Polly Town, and we're going to recount it for you right now, on this very stage, live.
Right here.
Fully improvised. So, can someone please tell me, what is the first location we're going to see and hear the story?
Saloon.
The saloon. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's been a day, hasn't it, Delilah?
Joe, let me tell you, I just don't know how much longer I can work in these sugarcane fields. They keep lowering my pay. It's getting hard to pay for my nightly triple whiskey.
Oh, Delilah, this one's all on me.
I need it, Joe.
Top shelf?
Make it middle.
Middle shelf.
Delilah's not that fancy these days.
I knew you were an economical woman.
Yeah. Joe, I heard you've been having some trouble here at the saloon.
Well, Delilah, things ain't been as good as they used to be.
Thanks.
There's a...
Buy one for yourself.
On me.
On me? Oh, well. I'm not one to refuse a free drink. Now, have I heard those bank scoundrels been hounding you again?
They have. But to be honest, I can't blame all of it on them. You see, this town, Polly Town, sugar cane's been our industry for decades.
You don't have to tell me. My granddaddy came here with the first sugar cane plant from Texas.
Oh, I remember hearing about that. Mm-hmm. My mom told me all about it. Well, see, all this work in the sugar cane fields, folks are getting a little bit more healthy, so to speak. They're not drinking whiskey as much. They're getting more into water and clean living. Heck, I even heard some of them are getting experimental by loving multiple people at once. I'll be damned if that's gonna be me, but.
Oh, I.
More power to them.
Seems totally strange. I could never.
Hey, how's things at home? I heard you guys were encountering some difficulties raising a family.
Well, you know, I don't like to air my dirty laundry, but...
Oh, Delilah, all laundry's welcome here.
You know, we've been trying to start a family, me and Bradley John, but ever since I've been visiting the saloon more regularly, it seems so hard to conceive.
Well, there's a new doctor coming through town. I've heard he's experimental to some extent, but perhaps you might find some benefit there.
Oh, doctor. Oh, do you think he's expensive? Brad and John and I don't have much.
Well, Delilah, since he's new to town, I reckon he might cut you the deal. Any man of health and medicine tends to be a man of the people, supporting those less fortunate, like you and I.
I guess it's worth a try. Thanks, Joe.
Brother? What's that, Frederick?
What'd you ask me up here to the farm for?
I had a bad dream last night. A real bad dream?
Not another one of them bad dreams. Last time you had a bad dream, all the cows done killed over dead.
I know, because I'm dreaming to die.
Who died?
Well, I was you that I died.
You died? Oh, no. But it ain't gonna happen this time. I mean, wait. When you had your dream,
yeah.
Was the man wearing white there?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Because that's what happened in the last dream. God damn!
Listen to me.
What are we gonna do?
Listen to me, Christopher. I don't want to die without at least having an experience with a woman.
Frederick, you're still a virgin?
Yeah.
Last week. You chickened out again? Frederick, come on. You know I can't afford the 50 cents.
I want real love.
Real love?
I want real love, Christopher.
I mean, you gotta go out there, you gotta find it.
Okay, I already did find it.
Oh.
It's Maybelline.
Maybelline?
Yeah.
Oh. You don't want Maybelline.
Why not?
Just trust me. She's not the right sort for you, brother.
She's exactly the right sort. She's a good gal. She goes to church every Sunday, and I go to church every few months. But this, I really know that she's the one for me when I see her.
Here's what I'm going to do, Frederick. Since I'm such a good big brother, and since I'm always looking after her, I'm going to go talk to her for you. Well, how's that sound?
You going to do that? You're going to talk to her for me, Christopher?
I'm going to talk to her. I'm going to talk you all right up. I'm going to tell her how big, strong, strapping young man you are.
Tell her that I got a good aim and that I can really get the cows all together and all that stuff.
Wrestling. Yeah.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
And we both know that I don't actually do that, but she doesn't know that.
I'll talk you up. You don't worry, Frederick. You know, you just leave it all in my hands. Where have I ever steered you wrong, brother?
Listen,
and don't mention that one time I steered you wrong.
You know, maybe I should have started with fitting to a gal like her. I gotta be who I am.
Brother, I'm gonna tell you something. Fibbing's all you got. You ain't got nothing up here.
Okay.
Lord knows, you ain't got nothing down there. But that's okay.
I got a lot in here.
You got a big old heart, brother. You know what? Don't worry. I'm going to talk to Maybelline, and I'll have her eating out
of your hand. I can trust you. I always know. I can put my life in your hands, and you'll never betray me.
Not even once.
Let's go.
Howdy, folks. Come on down and sample some Dr. Parnassus' fancy potions, medicines, and whatnots. Finest love potions you can buy east of the Mississippi and west of the Rio Grande. Howdy, folks!
What you got there?
Well, you see on this wagon, I have a special for the two of you. I can see a twinkle in your eye.
Pa, this... It's Dr. Parnassus.
Very same, sir. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. And should I know?
Maybelline.
Maybelline. Well, to my eyes deceive me. Why I sell love potions, but why you wouldn't need one, Maybelline. Any man would be a fool to deny his love for you.
Why, I can't believe a man would talk to me in such a way right in front of my pa.
Oh, man. That's just a salesman tactic.
Yeah. He doesn't mean much.
Now, sir, I have a keen eye for people. I can see, oh, dear me, that your wife is long gone, passed away on this great world. Is that right, sir?
Yes, she had too much sugar. She died.
Poor mom. Her blood sugar was just...
Yeah, they say sugar's not good. what this town's built on.
Well, I have a special deal for you, sir. Why, I have a lovely medicine here for glowy old men. Why, you take a sip of this and you'll be feeling warm all night.
I'm always feeling warm. Hey, gentlemen, this man right here, he got himself a very specific ailment. One he's a little bit embarrassed about. Can you tell us what that ailment is? Can you guess? That's right. He's Yeah, you got a hard time with your willy.
Now, Dad, Pa, you've been seeing the doctor for some issues.
Well, as I was saying, I'm not worried about me being warm for the women. I'm worried about the women being warm for me and me being able to perform.
I see what you're talking about, sir. Well, I tell
he's
you.
He's a stage performer, see? he does the shoot-offs.
Am I not in the presence of greatness? Now, sir, this here potion, while it'll make your lips snake, fine and hard as a 12-barrel. Tell you that. You know what? I have an extra special deal for you. Money? That's off the table. How about this? I trade you that, and maybe your daughter would like to share a night with me.
I'm not trading my daughter for no potion.
How dare you make such a proposition? I am a fine woman who goes to church every week.
Oh, no. You misunderstand me. You see, I make a lot of money selling potions and medicine. And why, I saw you and I thought, well, this is an enterprising young lady who would like to be a part of such a business. Wouldn't you like a business opportunity, ma'am?
Right, well, this town has fallen on hard times. People are not buying sugar the way they used to.
Yeah.
But I would like that potion.
Pa, are you really saying that you want me to spend a night with Dr. Parnassus?
No, I don't want you to spend the night with Dr. Parnassus.
Ma would have never wanted you to say something like that,
exactly.
Pa.
Exactly.
Well, I'm only in town for a little bit, and then, this is gone into the wind.
You go ahead and have the apples, okay?
All right, I'll be back.
More for me.
Dr. Parnassus.
Yes, Maybelline.
There are some things that my father does not know about.
Oh, dear. Do tell.
Well, see, this town has seen an influx of certain new ideas. And I have recently been asked to join in a polyamorous affair.
I see. You want to ask me for one of my potent love potions, which will make all the men slobber over you. I understand perfectly. That's what you're asking. No, I'm wrong. There's something else.
Can you guess what she's really asking? What is she really asking, Dr. Parnassus?
To join her.
To join her. That's right.
See, it's not that. It's just that the couple who asked me to join in with them, they're not gonna do it all for me. And I need a tall drink of water to be there alongside me. You wouldn't happen to know tall drinks of water, would you?
Well, as a medical doctor, I know the human body is composed of nearly 70% water. Mine is 69%.
Dr. Parnassus, you once said the perfect thing.
Be around, and you know what? I'll see you and your friends a little later, Maybelline.
Well, thank you.
General, I'm gonna need you to fix me up something strong.
All right.
From the top shelf this time.
Top shelf, Christopher, it is.
I done found myself in a pickle, my friend.
Oh dear, what's it this time?
Well, you know my little brother.
So yeah.
Yeah, he's a good fellow. Not too bright in the head.
Yeah, he's got a good heart.
He's got a good heart, but you know, he always weirds out the woman. He's always going around smelling everybody's hair. I just never quite understood that. So here's my dilemma. He's done taking a liking to young Maybelline.
You don't say?
Yeah, I do say, which isn't in itself too much of an issue. The problem is where things get a little complicated. Me and the missus have been trying to spice up things in the bedroom, and, well, let's just say we've been propositioning her.
Oh.
Yeah. And I just don't know how to tell my brother that me and his girly fancy are trying to have a three-way.
Well, in these progressive times that we're entering, this is something that has been known to come up time too. So I will say that he might not be too surprised by it. Nevertheless, you're his brother.
It is my brother. If it was anybody else, literally anyone else in this town, I wouldn't think twice. Literally anyone else in this town. But he is my brother! And God dang it, if it don't just eat me up inside!
I tell you what, I got a proposition for you.
Oh, another one! Don't get me excited now!
Here's my proposition to you.
Spit it out!
Your brother's in love with a potential mistress, yes?
That's right.
We are trying to redirect his attention and love to anybody else in town, as I hear it. Tell you what, Delilah, you know Delilah, right?
My wife, yes, I know her.
Oh, yeah. Wonderful.
You know what? I think I'm getting a connection for the next.
As they might call it back in the day, the old switcheroo. But in order to facilitate something like this, I'm going to need you to drop that massive investment that you got from your paw into my bar. In order for this bar to stay alive here, I need some so-called angel donors.
Now, Joseph, after last winter, when we done lost all our cows, my daddy's money is the only thing that's keeping us afloat. Now, what assurances do I have that you're going to be able to repay the debt that you owe to me?
If you're able to give me that massive amount of money that may be slowly trickling away, in exchange for me facilitating the old switcheroo with your wife and that lovely young Maybelline and your brother.
Delilah, I got your letter here. It said to meet you at your house alone. Well, here I am. What is this all about?
Frederick, I put away the dishes. Oh, did my husband Bradley John Christopher send you this letter?
No, it says it's from you. Do you need help with anything? I'm going to clean up your backyard or something for you. I can haul in the hay.
Yeah, you could help me trim the hedges out back.
Yeah, I can help you trim the hedges.
Okay, let me just look for the shears. How's it going looking for work?
Yeah, not too good.
No?
My mind's been pretty occupied with something else. You know,
here they are.
You know, I'm 21 years old, and I ain't been with nobody. And Delilah, I don't know how many more years I got left. Now, you keep having dreams about dying.
Frederick, as I've said before, I do think this is a conversation a bit more appropriate for you and your brother, my husband.
Well, yeah, I talked to my brother, and he said he's going to help me with Maybelline.
Oh, well... Bradley John Christopher, God bless his heart, even though he won my heart and soul an undying, unwavering loyalty and affection. I never was all too good in the romancing department. Now, maybe I can help you with Maybelline. Is that what you want?
I didn't think about it that way, but sure.
Right, well, what are her interests now? Let's see, she lives with her pa on that apple farm,
yeah.
So maybe you could talk to her about various fruits or...
Hey, how about